From afar, you'd think this is a river. But underneath the floodwaters of Nyatike in Migori County are homes and livelihoods submerged. With their farms underneath, they try to salvage what they can. With some fishing in the dangerous waters, in Nyatike alone, over 1,000 families are now homeless. And this is a rescue boat which will hopefully rescue people whose homes have been marooned by the floods. And for those who are lucky, they are able to salvage a few things and head to this primary school, a school which has been converted into a rescue center by the Kenya Red Cross.
We have medical personnel in those two camps that is taking care of any needs that may come as a result of maybe waterborne diseases and the like.
So far, the government has confirmed that at least 36 people have lost their lives in flood-related tragedies countrywide, with 2,393 households now left homeless since March, the beginning of the rainy season. But it is feared the number has risen since Thursday, when President Uhuru Kenyatta directed permanent secretaries in 10 ministries to develop a comprehensive plan of action to mitigate and manage the flood crisis in the country and report back to him within 7 days. This after a crisis meeting chaired by Deputy President William Ruto with 10 permanent secretaries on Wednesday evening. But leaders from the region say they're not convinced.
And that action plan we shall share with you next week. And in this action plan, we are also coming up to the budgetary provisions.
The minister in charge, I know they have not been appointed, but there's already a PS called a Mondo. Let him take a chopper and go and see the situation in Nyatike. Not sitting in Nairobi while people are dying there. 1,000 families plus.
It's not any favor that we expect the government to move as fast as possible, instead of wasting time merrymaking in Nairobi here.
But Kenyans may have to wait a little longer for the permanent secretaries to come up with an action plan with short and long-term solutions. This as the Kenya Red Cross has issued an alert to people living along the banks of River Tana following the rising water levels, and the river could burst its banks any time from now. According to the humanitarian organization, over 2,000 people have been displaced in the region. In most parts of the country, transport has been hampered with major roads cut off. Judy Kosgei, Citizen Weekend.